Working and navigating in CCSQ QualityNet Slack is a snap. Keep watching to learn how to get started in 5 easy steps. Now that you have access to CCSQ QualityNet Slack, you're ready to take advantage of all it has to offer. Slack is a great tool for collaboration and real-time communication. Here are some quick tips for navigating Slack. Step 1. Getting set up. First, log into CCSQ QualityNet Slack by opening your desktop app or through hiccus.slack.com. Now let's take a look at the screen. Verify that you're logged into CCSQ QualityNet Slack by locating Hiccus in the top left corner of your screen. At the top right corner of your screen is your profile. Click on it to edit your personal information, the name you'd like displayed, your photograph, and more. In the drop-down menu, select Preferences to select how often you'd like to receive Slack notifications, size of screen text, and more. Step 2. Using Channels. On the left-hand purple navigation sidebar, you'll see the Channels section. Think of channels almost like a chat room for different topics. Channels can be public or private. Public channels can be joined freely by any member. You have been automatically added as a member to the CCSQ Kudos channel. Private channels can be joined by invitation only and are signified by a lock icon. Their content is only visible to channel members. Click on Channels to view all public workspace channels. You can also use the search bar at the top of your screen to search for specific channels, as well as messages, files, or people. If you cannot find a channel on your topic of interest, you can start a new channel by clicking on the plus sign next to the Channels heading or at the bottom of the Channels section where it says Add Channels. You can have a channel for any project or interest group that you like. Step 3. Setting up notifications. When people chat in channels, you'll receive notifications with the number of unread messages waiting for you. Choose which channels you want to instantly notify you when there's a post. Right-click the channel name, click Change Notifications, then select either Every New Mention or Just At Mentions. You can change other notification preferences by clicking on your profile at the top right corner of the screen. In the drop-down menu, select Preferences. In the pop-up window, you can enable notifications, select when you'd like to be notified, select certain keywords you'd like to be notified about, adjust your notification sound, and more. Step 4. Direct messages. Below the channel section in the sidebar is the direct messages section. Direct messages are for person-to-person communications and group chats. Direct messages behave just like channels. When you have a new message, the sender's names will be highlighted in bold in the purple navigation sidebar with the number of unread messages waiting for you. To start a message, click on the new message icon at the top right corner of the purple navigation sidebar. Type the recipient's name in the to field of the message box, then type your message. You can adjust message formatting, use emojis, upload and share files, and even make a voice or video phone call, including screen sharing capabilities. Step 5. Join key channels. Be sure to join a few key channels, including help-slack for quick info, tips, and tricks about Slack, announcements-slack for Slack news and important alerts, and help-service-center-SOS for when you need to reach out to CCSQ Service Center representatives regarding QualityNet IT services. More Slack training materials can be found on the QualityNet Slack Confluence page. See? Told you it was a snap.